start my talk. I'd like everybody to stand up. Everybody stand up because I think you are getting bored and sleepy. Take some of your hands at your hip and take two deep breaths. One, two. Raise your hand. Stretch. And move your head back and forth. Issues with The First and Second World War happened in a deeply religious Christian nation. Russia, Germany, France, Hungary, Poland, and Germany. This happened in a deeply Christian nation. Second World War also occurred in a deeply Christian nation. We have the United States of America was involved in the Second World War. We have also Canada, Australia, and these are all deeply Christian nations. And at the heart of Europe, part of Europe, European culture, is Germany. And you know, that's where Martin Luther started the Reformation. But Holocaust happened. There were 6 million Jews that were killed in Germany, which is also a deeply Christian nation. The Reformation started. So what happened? The only one of the reasons is that because of the Christians, good Christians, keep climbing. We are supposed to be the salt of the earth. We're supposed to be the light of the world, a city on top of a hill. But if we fail to do that, then chaos happens around us. Even in the United States, the recent Pew Research, the normally Pew Research on religious aspects of life in America. The last 2020 results was that 60%, 60% of Christians of the United States are no longer believers, 60% are no longer believers. And between 50 to 35 years of age, 50% of the young people has abandoned entirely religion. This is very unfortunate. And in the United States, there have been like 60 million babies aborted for the last 50 years since Roe versus Wade was legalized. And right now, there's a lot of social issues. We have racism, gay marriages, and also we have issues with gender dysphoria. So it's really unfortunate that we are living in this world right now, and looks like culture is falling apart. The church is not to be blamed, but the blame is on you, on us, you and me. We need to be born again. Problem is, we're not born again. And when you go home tonight, for example, you know, I'd like you to read John 3, verse 1 to 17. John 3, verse 1 to 17. And this is a story of Nicodemus. I'd like to have a perspective on this story of Nicodemus. The story of Nicodemus is already written in John's epistle. You cannot find it in Matthew, Mark, or Luke. It's only written in the Gospel of John. And historians mention that the epistle of John was written like 30 or 50 years after the crucifixion of Jesus Christ. And these historians believe that Nicodemus went to John and told him the story of his encounter with Jesus Christ. And this is a very fascinating encounter, as you read, I'm not going to be reading it right now. John 3, 1 to 17. And in that context, we've been trying to decipher and see exactly what this encounter is all about. The